This module is about how pressure and temperature affect the solubility of a solute in a solution. So, pressure. First of all, if the solute is a liquid or a solid, then the pressure of gas above the solution has no appreciable effect of the solubility of that liquid or solid solute. So that's easy. However, if the solute is a gas, then the pressure above the solution does matter. In particular, what matters is the partial pressure of the gas that's dissolved in the solution above the solution. And it ends up that the solubility of a gas that's in a solution, dissolved in a solution, is directly proportional to the partial pressure of that gas above the solution in certain situations. This is called Henry's Law. You should memorize it. C equals Kp. Here, C is the concentration of the dissolved gas. The units of the concentration, by the way, depend upon this. This is called Henry's Law constant. And you'll find Henry's Law constant in different units. We're going to use moles per liter atmosphere here. And P is the partial pressure of the gas that's in the solution above the solution. So K depends upon that particular solution, that particular combination of solute, gas, and solvent. Now, Henry's Law does not apply. There is not this linear relationship when it's not a dilute solution and when the gas that's dissolved in the solution either reacts with the solvent or dissociates in the solvent. And if that's the case, then Henry's Law is out the window. For example, hydrogen chloride by itself is a gas, and if you were to dissolve it in water, then the hydrochloric acid that forms dissociates immediately into hydrogen ion and chloride ion. Hydrochloric acid is a strong electrolyte, which means that it completely dissociates into the ions, and that dissociation will affect the concentration of hydrogen chloride gas that's dissolved in the solution. So Henry's Law does not work for that. But there's a lot of instances when we can use Henry's Law. For example, let's suppose we have a bottle of beer, right? And when it was bottled, they pressurized that bottle with carbon dioxide gas to a pressure of 4.8 atmospheres at 22 degrees Celsius. We can use Henry's Law here to calculate the concentration of carbon dioxide that's dissolved in that beer before it's opened and then after it's opened. And now, other things we have to know are, first of all, what Henry's Law constant is for carbon dioxide in water, and it's this number right here. And we also have to know what the partial pressure of carbon dioxide is in just the normal atmosphere. Now, let's assume it's about one atmosphere. The atmospheric pressure is about one atmosphere. And then it ends up, because there's only a small fraction of the atmosphere that's actually composed of carbon dioxide, it ends up the partial pressure of carbon dioxide is about this, 0.00040 atmospheres. Okay, knowing that, all we're going to do is plug into Henry's Law, find the concentration before we open the bottle and after we open the bottle. So, before we open the bottle, we take Henry's Law constant, that's just the K, times the partial pressure of the carbon dioxide above it, which is 4.8 atmospheres. Multiply them together and we get 0.148 moles per liter, two sig figs to get 0.15 moles per liter. After we open it, opens up, carbon dioxide gas escapes, and all we have is essentially is the atmosphere with this many atmospheres as the partial pressure of carbon dioxide above it. Plugging into Henry's Law again, this is K. This is the partial pressure of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. We get this number, 1.24 times 10 to the minus fifth molar, 2 sig figs, 1.2 times 10 to the minus fifth molar. And you can see here that it's about 4 orders of magnitude, roughly, difference between before we opened it and after we opened it. So where does all that gas go? It's, some of the bubbles that you see coming out, that's where it's going. That's why they come out. Okay. Now, temperature. What effect does temperature have on the solubility? Well, if it's a solid, then increasing the temperature for most solids increases their solubility, but not all of them. However, if it's a gas that's a solute, then across the board, if you increase the temperature of that solution, you decrease the solubility of that gas. So these graphs here just give the solubility of some solids as a function of temperature, And most of them certainly increase, some more than others. Potassium nitrate has a real sharp curve here. Notice potassium chloride, it's pretty shallow curve right here. But some of them, the solubility decreases as you increase the temperature, sodium sulfate and cerium sulfate. And we talked a little bit about that before. These are gases, okay? Solubility times 10 to the minus 3 moles per liter. And as you increase the temperature, their solubilities all decrease. And that's that.